the other day. There's Marianne Vos, the World Cup leader, in the red and white as she takes off her final jersey. Caitlin Keogh about to get started. She knows that it's important to have a good start today. Anna-Marie Verst, the European champion. She's had a very consistent season so far. So the European champion ready for racing alongside her, the world champion, Sanna Kant. It's not really going to current form as far as world championships, world champions are concerned for Sanna Kant so far. Alicia Azzuffi of Italy, one of the emerging talents of cyclocross. Then Lo Sells alongside riding for the Powers Vascot service team. And finally, the rider who won in Namur, Lucinda Brand, also the winner, of course, in Tabor earlier on in the season. That's the front row of the grid. Very important here to get a good start. It's a little bit like a kermesse race today in Zolder. It's very hard under the wheels. And 30 seconds now until we get this race underway for the women. It's going to be very important to get off the start quickly. All the riders recognize that. That's been the talk of the pit area before the race starts. Counting down then until we get underway. Underway then for all of the riders, 87 riders powering their way off the start line. Katie Compton looks to have had a very good start. And also in the middle, Sanna Kant is having a good start too. As they go past my commentary position, it's Christine Majeras and Katie Compton who are the first riders off this start line. And for Katie Compton, this is a tremendous start. Marianne Vos moves up on the right-hand side. Majeras is alongside her. They're going to go up to this first corner. And through it is going to be Marianne Vos, followed by Christine Majeras. A crash here. A few riders taking a tumble. That's going to hold some riders up, particularly those who are towards the back of the grid. Vos leads. Marianne Vos. Oh, Anna-Marie Verst has been held up. So has Yolanda Neff. That's not good news for the European champion and for her overall World Cup hopes. Denise Betsema already into the pits on the left-hand side. Let's just take a look here. What happened? One rider came down in the middle. Yolanda Neff is held up on the right, skidding into the barrier. And I think the rider who came down first was Anna-Marie Verst. She was first to hit the deck. It's a little bit like a kermesse race today here in Zolder. It's very, very hard underneath the wheels. Marianne Vos, the leader. And Vos, of course, six times the winner here in Zolder. Fifth last year. And she's starting to put the pressure on everyone behind. And talking to the riders before the start, I spoke to Christine Majeras. She said she recognised how important it was to get a good start, said that this course really isn't her ideal course. I suggested that maybe the fact that it feels like a road race might be good for her today, but she said she just hasn't been feeling on top form so far this season. The training's going well, but when it comes to racing, she hasn't been feeling good at all and was hoping that today would go well. Let's just see where the European champion is and also where Yolanda Neff is. There is Denise Betsema, the winner in Coxsackie, who you'd expect to go well here. Marianne Vos opening up an advantage already. She knows this course so well. The opening lap last year was an 8:30. We'll see what the opening lap is this season. Vos really putting the pressure on. Just a couple of seconds her advantage now. Maybe 2 seconds as she makes her way around these turns. You can't slide the bike at all. It's a little icy. Majeris now trying to follow behind her, Brammeier. Then it's Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado. This is a great start for her. Behind her, the world champion Sana Khan. Then Katie Compton, Lucinda Brand in the Orange's Lost Cells. Watching the rest of the riders. There's Ellen Noble, then Caitlin Keogh. And another slide as one rider hits the deck. Mariana Voss opens up maybe 3 seconds now, her lead. She's treating this almost like a road race. Nikki Brammeier trying to get past Christine Majeres. Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado recognizes that you cannot let Mariana Voss take this amount of a lead already. There's the European champion who's now in traffic. And she's got to find her way through, which is going to be extremely difficult, because normally where you would ride, you're going to be held up by riders who don't have that technical ability yet to ride certain sections of this course. Second place then, Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado. Nikki Brammeier is just behind as Mariana Voss makes her way back onto the next tarmac section. Be a good group of riders behind who may well be able to work together on the hardest sections of this course to bring Voss back. There goes Lucinda Brand round the corner. Ellen Noble behind her, Caitlin Keogh. And this is this traditional switchback section. Lucinda Brand talked to her just before the start. She was very, very pleased with her performance in Namur. Said she felt really strong on the day. If you get this a little bit wrong, your tire pressures are a little bit wrong, and you will slide off, as Nikki Brammeier now goes to the front. Voss is looking superb at this moment in time, but Brammeier is starting to come back to her. It's very lucky to Nikki Brammeier made me a cup of tea before the start. Well, in fact, Matt Brammeier made me a cup of tea before the start. And she was just chatting about how the season has gone so far for her. She didn't feel so good in Namur, but she was very pleased with the performance on the podium just a couple of weeks before that, where she finished fourth in Namur, was second in Coxsider. But again, she was talking about how important it was to get a good start, and was a little bit, not worried, but just thinking about the fact she was starting third row on the grid and how important the start was going to be. And she said she's just going to have to use her elbows a little bit and get through the traffic and get up towards the front. Sana Khan now in a position we've not seen her in a World Cup for a little while. And look at her season so far. She was injured at the beginning of the season. You look at Sana's performances, and so far she's been really struggling. She's not been on the podium of a World Cup yet this season. And that is a big surprise. Mariana Voss being brought back now by Sana Khan behind her. Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado, Nikki Brammeier. Then it's Lucinda Brand, who again could be the dangerous rider. Eva Lechner goes through. Then Mariana Voss slipping and sliding her way up the steps here. It's not very easy. Sana now is closing the gap. You can just hear how hard these women are working. Steve Majeris had such a good start. These ruts are really difficult. The riders will be riding with slightly higher pressure in today. Let's just look at what happened here. Oh, that was a big slide. Naomi Rook hitting the deck. And now the chase is on from these three at the front. Brammeier has dropped back a little bit. She did say to me before the start, if if you are there with three laps gone, you're in with a good shout of winning this race. You've just got to hang on and be there. Marianne Vos at the front of the group now, working well. Lucinda Brand on the wheel of Nikki Brammeier, who asks her for a turn as they go across the line that time. And that lap was an 8.06 by Marianne Vos. Here comes Katie Compton, had such a good start. There is Anna Marie Vos. We'll get an update on where she is in a moment when she comes across the line. There's Kaylin Keogh. There is in the green, white and red, Eva Lechner. And Brand is towing Brammeier up towards the front. Sanna Kant in the lead. So an 8.06, the average speed of that lap, 22.95 kilometres an hour. Here comes Anna Marie Vos. She's going to be a long, long way down in this group of riders. Let's just see where she is now. It's a very, going to be a very difficult chase for her. Anna Marie Vos is now 26th, 44 seconds down. We may well see a lot of this race come back together at the front. There is Eva Lechner, who was third last year. Sanna Kant was the winner. Katie Compton was second. Eva Lechner was third. And now we have a group of riders riding it almost like a criterium race. Sanna Kant goes through the corner first. Marianne Vos second. Lucinda Brand third. Nikki Brammeier in fourth place. In fifth place, the revelation of this season, Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado. The chase is led by two American riders, Kaitlyn Keogh and Katie Compton. Christine Majeras at the back of that group. If they just keep working here, this race will come back together. Could end up with 10 riders at the front of this women's race, but now a huge attack. Big attack by Sanna Kant. Marianne Vos goes with her. Lucinda Brand trying to shut the gap. Brammeier trying to work well as well. Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado losing the wheel a little, but Sanna Kant is really turning the pressure on. Oh, a crash from Lucinda Brand at the wrong time. That's going to give Sanna Kant and Marianne Vos an advantage. If you just take a little bit too much of a risk, then you have a problem. Brammeier were held up for a long time there by Lucinda Brand. Brand coming back though. She's recovered from that crash. She's a tough bike rider. These two riders going clear now. Vos looks around urgently. Brand coming into that corner, not relenting at all, so she's not fazed by that crash. The top 10 riders, let's just run through them for you then. Sanna Kant, Marianne Vos, Nikki Brammeier, Lucinda Brand. Behind them is Maud Kapteins. In fact, it's Kapteins and not Kaitlyn Keogh, who's now with Katie Compton. Then it's Luce Sells, Jana Chetnerova, and Christine Majeras. Then it's Kaitlyn Keogh at the back of that group now, and then Eva Lechner. There they are. There is Kaitlyn going through, now back towards the front of the group. And there's the under 23 leader of the World Cup going through. Ellen van Looy, good to see her back racing. There's Anna Marie Vos, starting to make her way back through the field. Well, thank you to all of you for watching here on the day after Christmas Day, if you celebrated yesterday. If you'd like to join us on Twitter today, at @UCI_cycling, at Ant McCrossan is where you can join us. Maud Kapteins is making her way across the gap now. Katie Compton on her wheel. Los Sells coming round to complete another lap. Not long until they get there. And Maud Kapteins may well get herself towards the front. A rider who rides well on these slightly flatter courses. She's won previously a round of the World Cup in Cox Sider. Anna Marie Verst in a proper race here after that crash. Now they loop left and Mariana Vos continues with the attack of the front. 9 seconds as she comes out of the corner, puts in a huge turn of pace. Both these riders with full leg warmers on, just trying to keep as warm as possible. And Vos now attacks Sanna Kant. Lucinda Brand is clearly strong the way she's riding. There's Yolanda Neff. Started way, way down the grid today. She started on the fifth row in Namur and ended up in fifth place. Today she's on the sixth row of the grid. Let's take a look and we'll see where Yolanda Neff is overall. She's now 43rd at 124. Sanna Kant struggling to stay with Mariana Vos. Vos really is putting everyone under a huge amount of pressure. Her record in Zolder is unparalleled. Last time she was on the podium, 2016, she beat Sanna Kant and Katarina Nash. She also won in 2014, 12, 11, 9 and 8. Also has finished on the podium. Finished on the podium in 2013 and 2010. So it's only been a couple of years since Mariana Vos has been on the podium here in Zolder. Sanna now has recovered, just took a little bit of a breather. It's the only really wet section of the course across the top here. And Lucinda Brand takes the long line round it. Sanna Kant comes back to the wheel now of Mariana Vos. And these two of daylight, 6 or 7 seconds to Lucinda Brand, who uses her power to get over the top there. Brand is slowly but surely closing the gap. She is looking determined and focused. Nikki Bramar with Maud Kapteyn's on her wheel. Katie Compton is coming back now. Compton, the winner in 2010 and 2013. Onto this drop-off. Bramar goes down in front of Kapteyn's. Katie Compton there. Compton had that virus and is now recovering well as we make our way towards the end of this lap. And I think Lucinda Brand is going to come back to the front of the race yet again. This rider is able to close these gaps at will at the moment. So an 8.06 for the first lap, as we now have four riders at the front. Lap number two, Sanna Kant with an 8.10 that time, but Lucinda Brand has just done a lap of 8.06, the fastest lap of the race so far. 22.96 kilometres an hour for Lucinda Brand. So the fastest lap times, Lucinda Brand, Mariana Vos, Sanna Kant, Alvarado in fourth, another 8.06. So now we have four riders at the front. Things may calm down for a moment, but Vos thought about going past Sanna Kant that time. Maud Kapteyn's is closing this gap again. She's ridden across to brought Compton across to Bramire, and now she is going to try and close the gap on the rest of the field. Losel's just hanging a little bit further back. Six laps there will be this time. Last year I think they did five laps. Vos just gives her neck a little bit of a click there. Looked like just trying to relax a little. But talking to Bramar and Majerus before the start, they both talked about the start being so critical here in Zolder, And Brammeyer, just remember, she said, if you're there after the third lap, then you're in with a shout. The important thing is just to try and stay there. Just looking to see where Yolanda Neff is now. She's now at 38th. I'm not so sure she's going to be able to recover the way she has in the last race. Denise Betsema a little bit further down today, but Anna-Marie Verst is now in 17th place. She's closed 3 seconds. There's Sophie De Boer, former winner of the World Cup. There is Yolanda Neff. This race is closing up. There's going to be now, I think, 7 riders at the front. It's going to be an enticing last 3 laps of this race as Kapteins brings Brammeyer and Compton up to the front of the race now. It's all about the concentration of effort and leaving something for the last couple of laps. The lap times last year, an 8:30 opener followed by an 8:30 second lap. Today they've done an 8:06 and an 8:10. Brad Walker, thanks for your message. Are those ruts actually frozen today or just firm and ultimately with some give? There's some areas of the course where the sun has been out, where there's a little bit of give in this section particularly, but there are areas that just feel like you're on tarmac. So it's just feels like you are on concrete, tarmac or anything else. So there is no give in some of the ruts at all. But in the sunny sections, things are a little bit easier. There is a little bit of give. There's Denise Betsema, followed by Ellen Noble. The top-placed riders at this moment in time, then Sana Kant, Mariana Vos, Lucinda Brand, Hayden Del Carmen Alvarado, Maud Kapteins, Nikki Brammeyer, Katie Compton, Lo Sells, Eva Lechner, and Jana Cechnarova. Comes from the Czech Republic. But at the front, Sana looks quite comfortable. Doesn't seem to want to take this on at the moment. Everyone has been riding pretty hard for the opening couple of laps. 22.9k an hour around this course. We are going to end up with 8 riders at the front. Just got to hang on all the time. Most of these riders, if they celebrated Christmas, did so on Christmas Eve. A lot of the riders yesterday, though, cooking a pasta or something like that. It wasn't a traditional Christmas dinner yesterday. The riders generally celebrating on the Christmas Eve, the 24th, as Lucinda Brand goes to the front. Anna-Marie Verst is having one of those days. She has been the most consistent rider all season. You look back through the results of the last few races, second in Bern, second in Tarbor, third in Coxsider, third in Namur. Lucinda Brand. Now she's back where she wants to be, at the front of the race. The Dutch champion, Nikki Brammeyer, is finding that little turn hard and is losing seconds, but now she takes the other line and that's helped her out a lot. Brand now puts the pressure on, jumps the wheels a little. I don't know if she's thinking she's punctured. There's Denise Betsema wearing number 24. The race really stretching out across the top of that little climb. So Brandon Vos, 2 former teammates on the road. It's really hard down this section. Literally the bike is bouncing all over the place and you get to the bottom, there's no give at all as Brand is first onto the steps. Fast feet, mounts really quickly. Now she'll stretch the race out to see if she can get rid of a few people. Sana Kant a little bit slower out the top of that climb. And Brand now really kicking on. She knows this is an important point. Mariana Vos goes to the right-hand side. Brand goes to the left-hand side. Just got to keep digging in, and the race might come back to you if you're towards the back a little bit, where Katie Compton is. And she'll know. She's won here before. She knows exactly how to ride this race. Mark Hamilton, just for you, will update on the Canadian riders. Let's take a little look. Jen Jackson now 27th, having a good race, 113 down on the day. Magali Rochette not having a great day, 132 down at 38th place. Then Ruby West, 39th. Now 87 riders in this race. Magdalene Valeriz-Mill, 47th now for the Canadians. So if you're cheering a nationality, cheering riders from a certain nation, let us know. As we now see these same four riders come back to the front. Voss is using the road to really good effect. There is Eva Lechner, ninth now, 21 seconds down. Coming up to the end of lap number three. Super fast today, it really is. Mariana Vos goes through. An 8:13 lap for Mariana Vos that time. No, doesn't get close to the lap time of Lucinda Brand. Going through then, Bramier and Sells, 14 seconds behind at the end of that lap. Then Eva Lechner riding a big gear, trying to get back towards the front of the race. Lichiar Zufi goes across the line. The lap time so far, 8.06, 8.10, 8.13. There's Ellen Van Looy, good to see her back racing. Had a pretty bad crash. She's now back on the start line. Behind her was Nicole Kohler, Swiss rider. There was Maud Kapteins. She got back to the front and now has been dropped off. A couple of riders leaving gaps. But Lucinda Brand is looking as comfortable as ever. Eva Lechner followed by Alicia Zufi there in the black and white kit with the treble seven on it. Anna-Marie Verst is not giving in. 13th place now at 38 seconds. She's almost got herself into the top 10. What would she have done if she hadn't fallen off at the start? She looks superb now. Laura Verdonschot there in the blue. Bramar and Sells trying to get back to the front, but it's Lucinda Brand who leads. Behind her, Mariana Vos in the World Cup leaders kit, and Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado, then Sana Kant wearing number one as the world champion. Maud Kapteins not far behind in the green kit. Just a stretched line at this moment, isn't it? Lucinda Brand kicks her way over the top. So if you'd like to message us at UCI underscore cycling at Ant McCrossan is where you can join us for today's Boxing Day. Zolder, the World Cup, freezing cold here. But loads of fans out by the side of the course cheering on these riders. The traditional Boxing Day cyclocross. Los Sales having her best ride for a few weeks. And then beginning February 2019, we have the World Championships in Bogensen. Los Sales this season, fifth in Waterloo. Missed out in Iowa and really since then has been inside the top 10, but not in the top six riders. Anna-Marie Verst is still full of fight. Eva Lechner, two Italians together. Alicia Zuffi. Well, looks like Inge van der Heijden is behind Azufi. Then Anna-Marie Verst catches Denise Betsema. Then Caitlin Keogh, then Ellen Noble. Noble still going well. And this rider, of course, the leader of the under-23 World Cup, Fleur Nagengast from the Netherlands. Brand trying to attack. Oh, Marianne Vos has got a problem here. Vos is left at the side of the track. Gets herself going again. Not what happened there, whether the gears have caught up, but Vos never panics. You can see just composure. Now she's got to get herself going. Marianne Vos left at the side of the course, and that might calm things down a little bit for a moment. Although Sanna's probably going to press on. There is Marianne Vos. Look at her go. She pedals her way back towards the leader. She's already passed Lechner. Now she's going to swoosh around here. Just watching Marianne Vos when she is like this shows you just how good she is. This is going to hurt the legs. But it may well bring some riders with her if she can get across. There she is, Marianne Vos. What happened here? So she looks down, and it looks like they just she was trying to change gears and something happened. Looks like the chain jammed and came off the front chain ring. Lucinda Brand senses that Vos is in a little bit of difficulty. Took her a long time to clear the problem, but the thing about Vos is she's so composed and so calm. Just no stress, was there? She's already on the wheel of Katie Compton. Sanna Kant's trying to use this to good effect. So it's Kant leading Lucinda Brand. Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado, then Maud Kaptines, then Los Sells, and Nikki Brammeyer. Behind them, a gap back to Marianne Vos, who's now bouncing her bike over that little ridge. And this race is going to come back together with nine riders at the front. Suddenly, riders who didn't have a chance do have a chance. Katie Compton right over the back of the bike, going with Vos. And now it's Kant first to the top of the stairs, followed by Brand. Few riders have been given a new lease of life here. Sanna Kant trying to put the pressure on. This is the area where there's a few riders suffering. Lucinda Brand goes with her. Helen Del Carmen Alvarado, then Maud Kaptines, then Brammeyer, then Los Sells. There goes Marianne Vos on an area of the course that she knows well and rides well. Kant is trying to put everyone under pressure. Helen Del Carmen Alvarado rode that entire section really well there. Kant's trying to accelerate to put Vos under pressure. Three riders now at the front. Maud Kaptines trying to go with this big acceleration. Vos is now onto the wheel of Brammeyer. She's caught Los Sells. This could well help Maud Kaptines. If Vos gets there, these two will go flying across to the front. They're not far off the lead now, 8 seconds. It's an amazing race, the way it keeps stretching like this. Coming up now towards the end of the next lap, and suddenly they've got another bit of daylight, but Vos is going to use her road speed to good effect. Kant looking around at Lucinda Brand, and they're playing into the hands of Vos now. There is Anna-Marie Verst, 12th now at 30 seconds. Crossing the line this time, Vos is going to drag three riders across. That lap 8.11 by Sana Kant. But Nicky Brammeyer just did an 8.03, and Lo Sells both an 8.03, 23.08 kilometres an hour as the fastest lap time. And actually, Inge van der Heijden, now an 8.01, was her the fastest lap time. But Anna-Marie Verst has just turned in a 7.55. Front of the race then, Brammeyer. The race now changes at the front again. There is Eva Lechner. This race is absolutely flat out. The average speed of the laps. Anna-Marie Verst has just done a 23.47 kilometres an hour lap, a 7.55. She's now into 12th place at 16 seconds. Is Anna-Marie Verst going to do the unthinkable here? The top 10 riders. Nicky Brammeyer, Lucinda Brand, Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado, Sana Kant, Mariana Vos, Maud Kapteins, Lo Sells, Inge van der Heijden, Katie Compton, Eva Lechner. But only a few seconds behind them now is Anna-Marie Verst, a European champion, who at one point in this race was 44 seconds behind the leaders. Mark Saunders, thanks for your message. Why does Yolanda Neff not get better seeding after her last result? The actual grid are done on a cumulative points basis every week on a 12-month basis, and that's why Yolanda's so far behind. Front of the race then is Brammeyer. We're on lap number 5 of 6. And the front of the race, riders who have ridden the road a lot. Brammeyer, of course, has ridden on the road, the Olympic Games. There is Yolanda Neff, number 87. Mariana Vos, a great road rider. Lucinda Brand, a great road rider. And they're using their road speed to really good effect here. Brammeyer now starting to put everyone under pressure. Sana Kant trying to go with it. Katie Compton around that turn. And Brammeyer starting to open up a little bit of a gap on the field. Brand brings it back. Mariana Vos in third place. So three riders who generally we know are good on the road are leading this race, but it's still anyone's race. Katie Compton. But look over there on the left-hand side. A European champion is almost back at the front of the race. After a crash, this is a superb ride by Anna-Marie Verst. Very impressive indeed. There's the under 23 leader. Ellen Noble is behind her. This race is really interesting as far as can the unthinkable happen for Anna-Marie Verst. Jana Czechnerova just went through the camera. Then Denise Betsema behind her, number 35. There is Marianne Norbert. But Nicky Brammeyer leads. Lucinda Brand has got to be the danger in here. But Mariana Vos in a sprint would probably beat all three of them. All the other riders, sorry, in this group. Going through Laura Verdonschot, one of the younger riders. Brammeyer looks around. Behind her, Brand, then Vos, then Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado. Alan Van Looy goes through the camera. Anna-Marie Verst's time on lap number 4 is absolutely stunning, the way she's ridden across here. When looking at the times I'm seeing, she's only 14 seconds away from the leaders now. The big attack at the front comes from Maud Kapteins. Mariana Vos reacts. Lucinda Brand onto the wheel. In the white is Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado. Arsenal attacks. You really got to just stay in the wheels now. Lucinda Brand, that was some little move there on the inside. How did she do that? Lucinda Brand taking the inside line, cutting across. That was a superb little change. Bramhauer's taken a totally different line to everyone this time and has done for every single lap. Superb racing so far. Mariana Vos right in on her wheel now, is Brand getting as aero as possible. Maud Kapteyn's in third. Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado in fourth. Sana Kant in fifth. Nikki Bramhauer in sixth. Behind her is, I think, Inga van der Heijden. And yet again, this race is going to come back together. Mariana Vos onto the steps. First to get back on the bike is Vos with a massive attack at the front. Vos knows exactly where you can put everyone under huge pressure, and this is what she does this time. Any one of these riders can finish on the podium. Kapteyn's into third. Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado in fourth. Sana Kant, or Nikki Bramhauer, doesn't manage to get up to the top of that hill, so she's going to slip back. And now we're ending up with two riders at the front, followed by a group of three. Vos now just bouncing the bike down that descent. Now, oh, that was a big turn there. Sana Kant unable to go with that acceleration that time. She's really got to get in the wheels here. Can she get on the podium for the first time this season in the World Cup? This time round, we're going to end up with one lap to go. And we've got two riders at the front, Mariana Vos and Lucinda Brand. Sprinting her way across, Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado. What a story it would be if she took this win here in Zolder. 40 minutes of racing have gone. This is going to be one of the longest women's races we've seen. It's going to be nearly 50 minutes of racing. Crossing the line this time. 15 and a half kilometres have gone. The lap time, 8.07 from Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado that time. Group of three just behind, and there is the European champion as she got the legs to get across. She's not far behind now. Anna Marie Vos, 17 seconds is the deficit. She's now in ninth. Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado now leads this race. Crossing the line here, we're in number 68. Jana Czechnigarova. Behind her, Denise Batsema. 44 seconds down. Los Cels refusing to give in. These riders really have raced a proper battle. Eva Lechner now with Anna Marie Vos. There's Lechner in the green, white and red. She's finished on the podium here before. Last year, Kant, Compton, Lechner. The year before was Vos, Kant and Nash. In the World Championships, you may remember, it was Talita de Jong, Caroline Marnie and Sana Kant. Sana Kant was the winner in 2015. Katie Compton was second. Ellen van Looy in third. Pauline Ferrand-Prevot finished on the podium here in 2014. Vos was the winner, Nash was in second place, and yet again this race is closing up. The rider really is able to exert their authority on it. Everyone seems to lose a couple of seconds here, come back. And Eva Lechner and Anna Marie Vos are not far from the front. Lucinda Brand tries to attack, Mariana Vos going with her. Vos jumps over that little rut in the road. this is such an interesting race. Who is going to win it? No one has been able to break away. It's like a lined out road race. Lucinda Brand at the front yet again, winner of a stage of the Giro Rosa, winner of Omelette Pet Noise Black, winner of Tabor here in the World Cup, winner in Namur. Can she get her hat trick of victories for this season? Brand has attacked. Now she calms down again. There'll be some riders who might surprise in here who just use the element of their attack to break away, because there's been riders washed away on every lap and then they've suddenly got themselves back to the front. So they're on the last lap. Their morale is going to be good. They might well be struggling, but their morale will be really high if they've not finished on the podium. Anna-Marie Vers now closing in. There she is. She's 10th for the European champion. Alicia Zufi in 11th. There's Katie Compton down in 12th at 26 seconds. Not far now from the end of this race. Thank you very much for joining us here. It's a pleasure to bring you today's coverage of this Telenet UCI World Cup Cyclocross. Only two more rounds to go after this, Point Chateau and Hoogeheide. These riders have been attacking each other. Marianne Vos had a mechanical problem. She's back at the front of the race. It's still anyone's victory here. And the rider at the back, Inga van der Heijden, we've not seen her at the front of a cyclocross World Cup. Brand just stretching it through this little section. Attacks hard, tries to get rid of Vos and can't. Brand is using every little bit of power that she has out of these turns. She said to me as she sat on the rollers, "I felt super strong in Namur." And she's proving it yet again as she stretches the race really hard now, Lucinda Brand. Onto this little tarmac section where she knows you click uphill and then you can put everyone into all sorts of pain. Brand does that. Look at that tongue out. She knows she's hurting everyone. But now Vos is going to take the initiative. Marianne Vos, six times winner here in Zolder. Can she take her second victory of the season, her third victory of the season? She won in Waterloo, she won in Bern. Kaylin Keogh won in Iowa. Brand won in Tabor and Namur. Betsema won in Kopsider. Marianne Vos attacks hard. Look at her go. Marianne Vos opens up just a few meters on the front of the race. Sanna Kant trying to go with this one. Her shoulders all over the place here. Lucinda Brand digs deep, gets back onto the wheel of Marianne Vos, and now she overtakes so she can relax a little. Superb racing from these two Dutch riders. Brand isn't giving an inch. Vos trying to go with this now. Onto the wheel goes Sanna Kant, wearing number one as the world champion. She's gone so many rounds of this World Cup without any podium finish. This would give the world champion a huge boost. Marianne Vos now overtakes Lucinda Brand again. Sanna Kant takes a little bit of time to get herself back onto the bike that time. She just couldn't catch her pedal. Marianne Vos attacks hard across the top. Fourth place, Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado. Vos now opens up a second here. Lucinda Brand didn't quite manage to go with the acceleration. Oh, a mistake from Lucinda Brand. Marianne Vos looks like she may well be riding away. She didn't make any mistake on that little climb. Is Vos going to take her seventh win in the Zolder World Cup? Marianne Vos downhill. Lucinda Brand trying to go back to the wheel of Marianne Vos. Cross attacks again. This is a superb acceleration by Marianne Vos. Looking absolutely superb today. Look at Marianne Vos go. This is going to be a win for Marianne Vos, I think. The boss of Zolder has done it. She looks around. Marianne Vos takes her hat-trick of victories here in the World Cup. Marianne Vos wins. Second place is Lucinda Brand. Sanna Kamp finally gets onto the podium. Marianne Vos, superb racing. Fourth place, Kaylin Del Carmen Alvarado. Fifth place is going to be Maud Kaptein. Shakes her head. She gave everything. Sixth place is Luz Sells. Seventh place, Nikki Brammeyer. Eighth place is going to be Inga van der Heijden. Ninth place, well done, Anna-Marie Verst. What a race. 44 seconds down at one point. Came back to 17 seconds down. Despite a crash, she finishes in ninth place. Going up to the line now, Denise Betsema with Katie Compton. Crossing the line now, enjoyed that, was Jana Cechnarova. Finishes in 14th place. And there's our under 23 leader, Fleur Nagengast. Behind her is Ellen Noble. Then Caitlin Keogh in the next place across the line, 17th. And it was Norbert in 18th. Laura Verdon shot there, wearing number 4. Just behind her, wearing number 90, the Swiss rider, Nicole Kohler. Marianne Vos was stunning today. Even having a mechanical problem, she still takes the victory. Her third of the season. She won in Waterloo, she won in Bern, she wins here in Zolder. But it's a track that she's pretty much made her own. Well, we wait now for all the riders to cross the line. Coming up to the line now, Ellen Van Looy wearing number 2. And alongside her, Magali Rochette. But Marianne Vos makes it lucky 7, her 7th win in Zolder. Sophie de Boer crosses the line. Former winner of the World Cup, she's struggled with illness, 34th at 3:14.